everyone, it's Jen, and happy Halloween to you guys. I am actually filming this on Halloween. It's almost 12 o'clock, and I have the day off today, and I thought that I would just do a little Halloween color and chat because I feel very festive today, and I'm hanging out with my little man who it's really the last year that I'm going to be hanging out with him on Halloween because he will be in school full-time next year, so it's a bittersweet kind of day, and it's a really gloomy, nasty day here on Long Island. It's raining, and it's about 66 degrees and humid as all hell. So I'm sweating. I have shorts on. I can't believe it's October and I have shorts on, but it is what it is. Instead of having a nice warm beverage, as usually we do on Halloween here in Long Island, I have an ice water because, like I said, it's super warm and icky. But it is supposed to stop raining around 2 o'clock today, which is perfect because the trick-or-treating and trick-or-treaters will start coming around 3:30 or so. So it'll still be fun for the kids. And I'm looking forward to it. I love giving candy to the kids. I always wanted to do that. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit. But I want to get started here. So I wanted to show this to you guys. I thought it was very appropriate for Halloween today. This is a Ralph. So, I don't know if it's really showing up all that well. Carla Mangana, who makes the Spooky Sweets coloring book, she sent this to me. She made this. It's like a little art card. She drew it and painted it and put lots of pink glitter and gold paint, I think it is, on here. And she has these in her house. She has a lot of gold skeleton heads, and she calls them Ralphs. So she watches my videos, and she does see my pictures that I post online. And I've gotten in the habit of whenever I color a skull, I make it a gold Ralph in her honor. So she sent me a gold Ralph. So I will be keeping this, and I thought it was very appropriate for Halloween. And I found this at Hallmark this year. It says, Happy Halloweeny. It is a little hot dog wiener dog, like my little Snowy. Of course, not the same colors, but I had to have this, and it does, it glows in the dark. So we've had this on the island as our little decoration this year. And we're gonna be coloring from Mounts 4. Now, this is one of my favorite Halloween coloring books that I have. I did one picture in this season. I'm working on another one. This will be my picture for today. I don't know what else I'll work on today. We'll see how the day goes. But we are gonna go through it a little bit. I'll show you the things that I have done in it. This is the one that I did this year. I think I used, if I'm not mistaken, Luminance on it. I wonder if the light could be a little bit better. I think actually it looks better that way. So I think I'm going to actually shut this extra light off and see. Is it better that way or is it too dark? It's very gloomy today, so I don't know how I'm going to make this exactly the best lighting. Let's see if I can. Is it better that way? Oh, I think it's better that way. Okay, let's try it that way. So I did this one this season with Luminance pencils. No markers or anything on this one, I don't think. Just gel pen. Yeah, just gel pen. I used glitter gel pen on the saddle. Yeah, my brain. So I did that, and I used some glitter gel pen around his eyes and stuff like that. He's kind of like a Day of the Dead horse, I think. So let me see what else I've done in here. I did this guy in 2017. He's a little seal, a little devil seal. He's cute. Also pencils, don't know which ones though because I didn't write it down. Did this one in 2017. I think that's when I got this book. I think this was the second one that I did in this book. This is the one we're working on now, and we're doing all different kinds of pencils on this one. This was the first one I ever did in this book. Obviously, no, it was not the first one I ever did in this book. I did the other one first because this one says November 2017, but I really like this one. And let's see, I think there's one more. Yeah, I did the bunny rabbit last year. So this was the only one that I did in this book last year, but this also, this is Luminance pencils, I know, because I wrote it down, and then just some glitter gel pen. So let me just play with the lighting one more time and see if the, I don't know if that one's better. I think that the lighter one is a little bit better. So we're going to stick with this one. It's going to be very awkward here because I have the light on top of me and the sand and all that fun stuff. But we're going to make do. So let me go back to the one that we are coloring. So I'm not sure how everyone celebrates Halloween or if you celebrate Halloween, but if you do, I hope you're having a fun time and I hope it's been a good day. And if I'm here keeping you company today on Halloween, thank you. I'm glad to be with you. So I am using Luminance pencils on this, Holbeins and Prismacolors. So I'm just going to get my pencils open. Here's my sharpeners. I'm sweating like you wouldn't believe. It is so, I'm like need to put the air conditioner on. It's that bad. So let me zoom in a little bit here. So basically I have the dog done and I'm working on the skulls right now. So I'm using Prismacolors for that. So I'm just going to pull out those pencils and get started. You may have noticed my little hand candy. I have tendonitis in this hand. I've had it for years and it had steroid injections into it and they've worked for many years, but today it's just out of control bad. It's swollen, but I can't color with that thing on, so I'm gonna have to take it off. You can see it's all swollen around there and in my wrist. But it'll be okay. I've just been wearing that because it makes me feel a little bit okay. My apologies. The coloring assistant needed something. So I'm going to go in and just keep working on these. So this year, 2019, is a very difficult Halloween for me because my little trick-or-treat buddy, my candy hander outer buddy, is no longer with me. Belle loved Halloween and she had a costume for every year that I had her, a different costume. I actually have a closet full of clothes downstairs of hers, including costumes from every year. I think the only year she didn't dress up was 7 years ago, when Sandy destroyed the house, Hurricane Sandy. There was no trick-or-treating that year for sure because there was no power in this area for 3 weeks, a month. I don't remember even what it was. It was 7 years ago, so I don't remember now. But yeah, there was no trick-or-treating. We were in the dark. So I had bought her a costume and she was supposed to be an angel that year, but she didn't end up dressing up because obviously there was no Halloween. So I think I didn't dress her up as the angel the following year. I think I just decided to get her a new costume. So I don't know if she ever actually wore that angel costume other than in like to take a picture. But she was my bud. She used to help me hand out candy to the kids and she'd go out on the porch with me and she loved it. She loved that everyone would rave over her and her costumes, and I mean she was with me doing that for 6 years before Emilio even came. And then all the years, you know, that he's been here, she's gone trick-or-treating with us in the neighborhood, and then at night when we hand out candy, she's been there. So this is my first year without her and it's hard. I miss her. You know, that's the bottom line. I miss my little girl and I absolutely 100% love my little Snow White. She's getting dressed up this year. If I haven't told you, I don't know if I would have told you or how I would have told you, but Emilio decided he wanted to be Jack Skellington this year. And he told us that I'm just sharpening my pencil. He told us that we all need to dress up also. So he is Jack Skellington and she is Zero. I actually found her little Zero costume. So she's going to be Zero. And we went to, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit more. We went to a Halloween party at Frank's office last week. They had trick-or-treating at the desks for the kids and they actually let us bring Snowy. So I will insert a picture here of Jack Skellington and his dog Zero. So as you can see, they were super cute. She's all ready for Halloween. She seems to like to dress up like Belle did. The Zero costume is a little bit difficult because the hat doesn't really stay on her too well, but she's very good about it. I mean, she's only 11 months old. She's a baby, and this is her first Halloween, and she's very good about it. She was so good at the party. She didn't bark at anyone. She let all the kids come up and pet her. She's very sweet, and she did really well, I have to say. And today, she'll be getting dressed up when we go out for trick-or-treats. And she'll be Zero again, and Dad is going to be Oogie Boogie, because that's what Emilio told him he has to be. And Frank made his costume with some burlap, and I am going to be Sally. So I have to do all my own makeup and Emilio's makeup. I've done Emilio's makeup 3 times now. He had a Halloween party at school yesterday, so I did his makeup for that yesterday, and now I'm getting to be a pro at Jack Skellington makeup, so I haven't tried the Sally makeup, so that could be a huge disaster. I'm not sure. We'll have to see how it goes, but I'm going to give it a whirl anyway, because it's what he wants to do, and I just look at it like this. There's so few years left where he's going to want to have us dress up or even care what we do. So I'm more than willing to do what he wants. So I'm looking forward to it. We like going out trick-or-treating. We don't go to very many houses. We'll see how many he wants to go to this year. Each year he goes to a little bit more. But we have some friends who do huge Halloween decoration displays in the neighborhood. And we actually have a big one at our house, and the kids love coming trick-or-treating here because we have all this stuff outside that the kids like to come and take pictures with and whatnot. So we don't stay out too long so that we can be here and give candy to the kids. And honestly, Emilio loves doing that as well. He's been looking forward to it. So it's going to be a fun day. My mom will be coming over later. And gosh, for as long as I can remember, I mean, even when we didn't have Emilio, we would go and we always have pizza on Halloween. So Frank will be coming home early today from work for trick-or-treats, and we'll be getting a pizza later and listening to spooky music. And hold on a second. My apologies. The landscapers are outside, and I had the windows open, and that's going to be quite loud, so I went and shut the window to try to block out some of the noise anyway. So I'm really looking forward to this day. I go back to work tomorrow, so I mean, I guess I could have taken the day off, but I had to take a lot of days off this year with the dogs passing away, so I'm kind of saving the rest of my vacation for the holidays, like around Thanksgiving and Christmas. So either way, it's going to be a fun day, and I'm really looking forward to it. I love Halloween. We had such a nice Halloween season this year. We went out and did a full festivity, I think almost every weekend since September. I think there was one weekend we didn't do anything because it was raining, so we didn't actually go anywhere or do anything. But I think on that weekend, we drove around the neighborhood and looked at Halloween lights. So we made sure to do something fun and festive every weekend. We went to a few of the like Halloween spirit stores this year a few times, so that was fun because they have all those big displays, and Emilio loves looking at those and testing them out and all that kind of thing. So we did that. We went to our typical place for pumpkin picking. Frank and I have been going there for 14 years since we first got together, and I first went pumpkin picking with Frank. And this year they actually closed. They decided they're not going to be doing the pumpkin farm thing anymore. So they weren't having the pumpkin picking or the hayride or the cornfield or anything like that this year. They had a death in the family, and I guess that they just decided that the Halloween stuff was too much work and that they didn't want to do it, so they're not going to be doing it anymore. So that left us kind of like, what are we going to do now? Because we weren't anywhere near home. We go out pretty far on Long Island to go do that stuff. So we found another place that I had heard of over the season that we'd never been to, called Stakey's. And actually, you can bring dogs to Stakey's, but I had left Snow with my mom because we had planned to go to our normal place, and you can't bring dogs there, although Snow goes with us most places. So we didn't have her that day, but we decided to go anyway, even though we didn't have her, and just try it out and see how we did. If we didn't like it, we're going to go someplace else pumpkin picking another day. But We ended up having such a good time, honestly. It was quite different than what we had, you know, been used to for pumpkin picking. We always would go to this nursery, so it wasn't like, it wasn't really a farm. I mean, they had animals, but it was a very small farm, let's put it like that. It was more like a nursery that we would go to. But Frank and I have been going there for years, so we just always continued to go there and bring Emilio there. But since that wasn't an option anymore, we went to this place, and it was ginormous. It was huge, and we had so much fun. They had a big, big farm that we got to walk through. I'll insert some pictures here. And we went on a hayride, and what else did we do there? They had food, like they had roasted corn and cider donuts and hot dogs and pretzels and stuff like that. So we got some of that stuff, and Emilio got his face painted, which I'm sure you saw in the pictures, and they never had that at the other place that we went to, so that was fun for him. We went on the hayride. I don't think we went through the cornfield. He didn't want to do that. What else did we do? We picked the pumpkins, and this particular place had the all-you-can-carry pumpkins for $40. So, of course, Frank was up to the challenge, and he got all these pumpkins for us, and he carried them all, and when you get done with that, if you're able to do it, they measure, like they weigh them to see how much you saved by doing it that way, and he ended up saving $15. So he did pretty good. He carried a lot. I don't know how he did it, but when we were out in the field, he got like a whole plan together of how he was going to carry these pumpkins. So he made me arrange them in a certain way, and I did it, and he carried them. So kudos to him for doing that. And it was a lot of fun. And then we went to go visit our fathers, because our fathers are buried kind of near there. It was actually closer to the other nursery place that we used to go to, so we had to go back. But it was still a really good time. And I was telling this to Mona. I was having a conversation with her a few weeks ago. We went to the cemetery. It was kind of late. It was like around 4 o'clock. And it's actually a military cemetery. So it's very well kept, and it's a beautiful, beautiful grounds. Frank and I have been going for years, and I had never been there until Frank and I started dating. So I never actually got to see my father's grave until Frank and I started dating. So we've been going all these years, and like I said, this day it was kind of late, and Emilio fell asleep in the car. So we decided we still wanted to go, but not wake him up. So what we did is we left the car doors open. Their graves, well, Frank's father's grave is really close to like the end of the property, so very close to the car. So I wasn't concerned at all about Emilio being in the car. Obviously the car wasn't on, we had the keys with us or whatever. And we left the windows open so that if he should wake up, he could just call us and we would hear him right away. So we got out, we walked over to Frank's father's grave. Like I said, we were only a few feet away from the car, so that was that. And Frank and I were putting the pumpkin down, and all of a sudden we hear a lady like laughing. And when I heard that, it was relatively close. I mean, I could hear the laughing pretty close. And on that note, I was like, we gotta get out of here, because if someone is that close, they're too close for me, for Emilio to be in the car by himself. So like I said, we were only a few feet away from him, but I'm a helicopter mom, and I just don't take chances. So I said to Frank, we gotta go. So we didn't hardly spend any time by Frank's father. So we got back to the car, because my dad is only a few fields over from Frank's father. Got back in the car, and as we start driving, there is literally, I'm sorry, you can't see what I'm doing. There is literally no one around us. Not a soul. There were no cars. There were no people. And Frank and I look at each other, and I said, you heard that lady laughing, right? And he was like, oh yeah. I mean, she sounded close, like she was only a few feet away from us. And guys, there was no way that anyone could have gotten a car and driven away that fast. First of all, if they were that close, we would have heard the car. And second of all, they wouldn't have been able to get back in the car and us not hear them drive away. That's how close it was. So we were freaked out. Let's put it like that. Then we get to my father's grave, because I mean, I didn't want to miss out on my time. We only usually go see them once a year. And Emilio is still sleeping, and my father's grave is very far from the car. It's like all the way in the back of the field. So Frank goes to get out, and I said to him, no. I was like, you have to stay with Emilio. I was like, I'm not gonna leave him this far away by himself in the car. I'm just not gonna do it. Nothing would have happened, but I still wasn't gonna do it. So I had walked to my father's grave by myself after we heard the creepy laughing. And I was like, come on, really? So I'm walking there, and the whole time I'm walking there, I had to distract myself because I was scared. I'm not gonna lie. And I was walking down to my father's grave going, I hate this. I don't want to be here. And I was just singing a song to distract myself so I didn't hear anybody laughing. And that I actually made it there, because I didn't know if I was going to make it there. I made it. I dropped the pumpkin. I said to him, Dad, take care of Snowy. Take care of Belle and Jack and Little Bear. And I'm out of here because I hate this. And I left. I walked back to the car singing my song to distract myself. I was never so happy to get back to the car before. Oh, my Lord. That was freaky. So Mike and I started driving through the cemetery to get out, and there was so much wildlife there this time. It was so weird. There was like I think we saw like 12 deer. We saw a gaggle of turkeys. I mean, I don't even know, maybe 20 turkeys. And Frank says to me, oh, that noise that we heard, that lady laughing, that was probably the turkeys. They make noises like that. I was like, turkeys sound like ladies cackling? I don't think so. I don't know if he's saying it to make himself feel better or what, but I wasn't buying that the turkeys were making that noise. So we saw the turkeys, and then we saw a groundhog? Yeah, groundhog. And Frank got a little video of him, too. And it was just such a weird thing. And as we were driving out of there, I said to Frank, you did hear that laughing, right? And he's like, oh yeah, I heard it clear as day. And I was like, well, I'm thinking, well, he thinks it's the turkeys, but I don't think it's the turkeys. So either way, creepy experience at the cemetery. And now I've shared my story for Halloween, so I hope it sufficiently creeped you. a creepy Halloween story for you. And one that happened recently. So anyways, we did that this season. We went to one that is an actual nursery here on Long Island. It's called Hicks, and they have a whole bunch of fall things. They have hay rides, and they have pumpkin painting and sand art and pumpkin bowling and ring tossing on the witch hat and pick your own pumpkins, and they have food trucks there. And Emilio went on the wagon ride with my mom, the tractor ride, because he's been wanting to do that with my mom all season. He's been asking. So since we went on with him at the pumpkin place, I sent him on the tractor ride with my mom so they could just go by themselves and enjoy. And they had such a good time. I don't think my mom was ever on a tractor ride before, because just not her bag. But she got to do it with her grandson, so I was so happy about that. Frank and I stayed back with Snowy. We had Snowy with us, and Frank got one of those like roasted corns, and Snowy is an absolute garbage pail. She'll eat anything, and I have a picture of her to show you eating the corn off the cob, and she was legit eating the corn off the cob, so I'll insert that here. And we did all the little things that they have there. Plus they have like decorations and stuff there. So it's a really nice little fall activity that we did. And then we ended up going to Barnes & Noble for a little bit, because they're not that far from there. And then at nighttime, what did we do at nighttime that night? I think we went out and walked in the neighborhood because it was like super warm. And we went and we drove around, we walked around and looked at the decorations in the, you know, the houses in our neighbors. And And then I think the weekend before that, it doesn't really matter, it was like the first weekend in October, we went to see the Rise of the Jack-o'-lanterns. And they have that at a place called Westbury Gardens. It's this big like mansion in Westbury, Long Island. And what it is thousands of carved pumpkins that they have. And the pumpkins all have different themes. I'll insert some pictures here so you can see what those look like. And I had been to it years ago with Frank, and like we went once, and then it was always too hard to get tickets to it, and I was never able to bring Emilio because the tickets are expensive. They're like, I think for the three of us was like $75 or something like that. And the event goes off rain or shine, and usually they sell out way in advance, and I'm never able to get the early tickets. I usually can only get them for like after 9 p.m. and it's hard when you have a little one because they're going to probably fall asleep. And if it rains and you don't want to go, you lose all that money. So it's never been like accessible for us to go. But this year, I just on a whim said to Frank, let me go look and see if I can get any tickets. And opening weekend, I was able to get tickets for Saturday night. And I think the tickets were for like 9:30. Now that Emilio's almost five, he can actually stay up a little bit later. So we went, and I was able to get discount tickets, so I think I got all three of the tickets for $52, and we had a blast. Emilio didn't know, like, what to expect, but when we got there and he saw all the pumpkins, like, you walk down this trail with all the different pumpkins that are carved into all different stuff. They have music playing, and it's so fun, and you can walk at your own pace. You don't have to go at a certain time. You can stay as long as you want to in there. And you just go around, you can take pictures, you can touch the pumpkins if you want to. I mean, I don't know why you want to, but if you do want to, you can. And it's so fun. They have actual pumpkin carvers there. And believe it or not, the guy that was there carving one of the pumpkins was carving a pug face. And I was like, oh my God, of all things to be carving, he's got a pug. So, Emilio fell asleep at about 10:30, so we were nearly done with it, so he really didn't miss much, but we had such a ball that particular night. It was freezing, and we got there, and I had bundled Emilio and myself up, but I didn't think to bring hats or gloves or anything like that. Now Emilio had three jackets on, so he was pretty warm, and I put his hood up, so he was okay, and we did bring his stroller, so it worked out for him. I brought him a big pumpkin blanket. He was nice and warm and toasty. He had light-up stuff, like we brought him a sword, and he had a light-up pumpkin, so he was all set. But I was cold, so when we got there, they were selling coffees and stuff, so Frank and I both got coffees. And that was nice, because that really warmed us up. And then Frank bought me... they had Rise of the Jack-o'-lantern hats, which you probably saw in the picture. So he bought me a wool hat, and I was so warm with the hat on. It was perfect, and I wore that, and I love the hat. It's awesome. So it was just really, really fun. We had a great time. It was so worth the money. And I, you know, if I could get tickets like that again next year for that time and for that price, I would definitely do it again because they have different stuff every year. It's not the same stuff every year. So... overall, we did a lot of really great Halloween stuff this year, and I'm very pleased with all the activities that we did. I think the only thing we didn't get to do was go apple picking, and we didn't have our hearts set on it. It wasn't something that like we had to do. It was like on the list of things that we could do, but we did everything that we really wanted to do. So I'm very pleased with it. We already have a list of things to do for Christmas season, and I'm just really looking forward to the holidays this year. I am and I'm not, because the holidays are bittersweet this year, because although Emilio is getting older and he really understands, and when we go see these things, you know, he can really participate now. but my babies are gone. My pug babies are gone. So this year in particular is going to be harder than others because this is my first year without them. You know, for all the holidays, this is the first time without them. So it'll be a little bit hard, but we'll get through it. And I have my little Snowball, and I love her very, very much, much more than I ever thought I could fall in love with another dog after my Belle. So we'll be okay. It's just hard, you know. You do what you can do, and you make it through, and you have to grieve and grieve again and just kind of deal as you happen upon these things. You know, you never know how you're actually going to feel until it happens. So we'll just make the best of it that we can. So that's that. I don't know if you watched my video in which I talked about going brain dead because Milo's got all kinds of toys playing inside there. He's playing with his Jack Skellington. I don't know if you saw the video that I posted with the paints, the metallic paints that I recently received from KJ Designs, but I have the shingles again. I'm telling you, I had them last year too, and my doctor thinks that because my immune system is so low, he's got a pretty good idea that every time like a serious virus comes into the house that I'm going to probably get the shingles. So go me. I mean, who doesn't want to be me? So I've been dealing with that, and this time, honestly, the pain has gotten bad now. It wasn't that bad when it first started. It hurt, but not like it is now. I'm like, really, even though the rash is all gone and I've taken all the viral medicine for it, damn, that nerve pain sucks. And I've been dealing with it in my back and my shoulder, and it's just a huge bummer, at least, let's put it like that. But, you know, doing what we can do and just going from day to day. Eventually, I know it'll go away, so is what it is. Could be worse. It just, I don't know if it's kicked up my psoriatic arthritis or what, but I think, like, you can see my hands are really, really red right now. It's really sore, and the arthritis is just really painful. It could be the humid weather too. That could have something to do with it too. I don't know. Either way, I'm just dealing with it right now, but it'll be okay. Like I said, eventually it will go away. I know it went away last time, and it will go away again. Just, you know, another thing to deal with. So that's what's going on over here. Anything else to really talk about? I mean, I've been reading a lot. I go through different waves of sometimes all I want to do is read, and sometimes all I want to do is color. Right now I'm on the coloring bandwagon. I've been coloring a lot this last week, whereas before I like didn't want to pick up my pencils at all. So I never know. I mean, I was reading tons of books, and now I've kind of taken a little break from the reading, and I'm doing some coloring. I also noticed that I'm having like a bit of a problem with my attention as far as the reading goes, which happens to me every once in a while. It's like the fibro fog thing. And when I find that I have to read a page like 6 times just in order to be able to understand what's going on, it's just like a fog thing that happens to my brain sometimes, and it will pass on its own. I think a lot of people experience that sort of thing, and it makes it difficult to read. So typically when I'm experiencing that, I will read a few pages and then put it down and go back to my coloring, or not even read at all if I find it extremely frustrating. Depends on, you know, how I'm finding it and what I'm experiencing, but it happens, and it's just a part of whatever this crazy old disease is. It just, like I said, it's like a fog, and it used to really, really irritate me, but now I know that like with everything else, it comes and it goes. So I just take it when it comes and work with it. And like I said, I'll focus more on my coloring or something like that instead of worrying about it, because I find that you can't fight these kinds of things. They are what they are. They're here, and they'll go away when they want. So, you know, you just gotta deal with it. Just like the pain. The pain is worse at times, and then other times it's not as bad, and you can deal with it. And rather than fight with it, it kind of behooves you to kind of just go with it. Just do what it wants you to do, and you'll feel better eventually, and then you can continue on with doing stuff in life. So that's the way I look at it anyway. That's what works for me. What works for me is not going to work for everyone, but just telling you what I do. Sorry, just reaching for some pencils. I'm using Prismacolors, Holbeins, and Luminance on this page. And I find that they all work really well. This is just Create Space paper. But if you do layers on Create Space paper, it's really not a problem. You don't have much of a problem with like too much white space or anything like that. So it's all about the layers. Or if you don't like to do that, you could do markers, like do a marker base or a gel pen on it if you don't want to do markers or something like that. I really like pencil work. It's my favorite thing. I have a whole bunch of markers and I like my markers, but at times they hurt my hands. So, depends on, you know, how I said things are going. If they don't hurt my hands, then I'll use them. But I'm a pencil girl. I love my pencils. I love working with them. I love learning new ways with them. I love trying to learn to blend better with them. So that's what I work with. And I mean, even when I put markers on a page, I've tried a few times this season to just put markers down and be done with it, and I can't. It just doesn't work for me. Unless I put pencils on top of it and do my blending, it just, for me, doesn't feel finished. And I don't particularly like my own page if I don't do it. And that's just me. Some people are perfectly fine with their markers, and hey, that's what makes the world go around, right? We all like different stuff. So, you can't see anything I'm doing. Oh my gosh. How annoying is that? I'm so sorry that you didn't see any of that. I am just running my mouth and on a tangent, and you didn't see anything I was just doing. So sorry. That was just like a huge kick in the nuts to you guys. I'm so sorry that I wasn't paying attention. Well, mostly people are not watching me anyway do this. Most people, I think, are just listening while they're doing something like cooking or cleaning or coloring themselves. So I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'm just not. I've come to realize, like, with my YouTube channel here, that it doesn't matter. You know, it's just a fun thing to do. It's not a business for me. It's just a fun thing to do, to hang out, make a video when I can or when I feel like it. And just to make it about fun for myself. If it's not fun, then there's no point in doing it. So if I colored something that you didn't see, oh well, it'll be all right. It'll all be okay. So what time is it? Wow. I've been coloring for about 40 minutes already, or at least making a video for 40 minutes. So I think I'll color the hat and then I'll call it for the day, because I want to hang out with my buddy, and Frank will probably be coming home soon. Trick-or-treating won't start until I guess like 3 or 3:30 when the kids come home from school, so we have time. I'm just putting my pencils away here while we're chatting, but yeah, so we have time until the kids come home. And I don't know, I guess I'll start getting my makeup on when Frank comes home. It's gonna take me probably a while. Like I said, I'm becoming an old pro with Emilio's makeup, so that's pretty good, but it's gonna take me a little bit of time to get mine going. So, okay, now I know I'm watching, so I'm in frame right now. So, what have you guys been doing this holiday, Halloween season, or your fall season? I'd love to know if you guys have done any fall activities, or if you have maybe like a favorite coloring book that you've been working on this season. What's funny, I've noticed like some people are doing like a whole bunch of Halloween pictures, but a lot of people haven't this year. Usually it's like a big thing, and I don't know if it's because like I'm out of loop on the Facebook pages and stuff like that. I don't know if that is the reason, because basically I only see people's pictures on Instagram, but I noticed not a whole lot of people were doing a lot of fall pictures this year, so that's interesting. But like I always say, whatever floats your boat, whatever tickles your pickle. I have a few books, like The Fall Girls by Deborah Muller, that I'm going to still be working in even after this season. Because, I mean, fall goes till, what, December or something like that? So I don't have to stop coloring. I'll probably stop coloring Halloween stuff. But the fall pictures with the pumpkins and stuff like that, I can continue on with that because why not? And that book in particular, The Fall Girls, has some ones with turkeys and stuff. So I will color some of those. I also, 2 years ago, I think it was? I think it was 2 years ago, around Halloween time. It definitely was 2 years ago, because I remember I had to get a root canal the day before Thanksgiving because I had like a tooth that was like crumbling and I thought it was a cavity and it was ended up being like an infected, it was not an abscess, but there was like an infection or something in the tooth and I ended up having to have a root canal on it. Anyway, not the point. The point is that I remember having to have that done, so I was relaxing the night before Thanksgiving after I made my desserts, and Shalene and I were doing a buddy color together in the Zemla Shnova book. Sorry about that. So, yes, Shalene and I were doing a buddy color out of the Zemla Shnova book. I never know how to pronounce that, by the Tomislav Tomek. You know that book. And I remember Frank was cooking that night. Emilio was, I don't know what he was doing. He was little. And he was probably watching his pad or maybe he was sleeping or something. And Frank was cooking and I was keeping him company. And while I was keeping him company, I was coloring in that book while I was doing my buddy color. And I remember like finishing it the next day on Thanksgiving or something like that. And it was such a nice time. You ever have some times like that where you work on something and it just really gives you a nice memory? You like enjoyed working on that so much and it just sticks in your brain of the time that you were working on that. Well, that's what happened with that time. So now last year I did the same thing. I didn't do buddy color, but I did work in that book, in the Zemel Sinova book. And now we have the other one, the Villain Sand book. So my plan is after today, I'm gonna start a picture in that book because that is a really detailed book and it takes me quite a long time to color it. And I'll color other things in between because I've really kind of broken out of that. I need to finish a picture before I start on another one. In fact, I have a lot of whips that I started that I haven't finished yet, which is fine, but I had such a nice experience working on that the night before Thanksgiving that I like to do that again. So this month of November, I'll be working on one of those pictures from that book. So I'm interested to do that. I also saw a video by Rebecca the Booknester. She's gone back to making videos, which is awesome. And she was coloring in that book recently. So it reminded me that I want to get back into that and color something else in there. And I have my book coming, it should be coming Monday, Fairy Miracles. Is that it? No. Fairy Celebrations by Clara Markova. I should be getting that on Monday. Finally released on Amazon last Friday, and it should be coming Monday. So I'm really looking forward to having that. I've been seeing so many cute pictures in that this season, and I won't get to do any of the Halloween pictures in it because obviously it'll come after Halloween, and I don't know, I don't want to color any Halloween stuff in it after the season. I'll just wait till next year, but I will have it for Christmas pictures, so I'm very looking forward to having that. And I did color a Halloween picture. If you look on my Instagram, you can see it from Fairy Miracles, I think it is, this season. I did the little bat with the pumpkin, so that is what I did. So that is pretty much going to be it for me. I'm just going to finish coloring this because my coloring assistant is starting to get restless and you're going to start hearing noise and stuff because he's been a good boy. He sat down almost the whole time that I was coloring and just watched his iPad. So I know he wants my attention. So I'm just going to try to finish this hat the best that I can. And at least you'll see me color something on here. Instead of being a ditz and not even coloring it on camera. And I've just been talking up a storm here today, so I would love to hear you talk up a storm. Tell me something that you did this season that you like, something that you watched, if you watched any scary movies. Did anyone go see The Joker? I have not seen it. I will have to get it when it comes out on DVD. But I know that was supposed to be like a psychologically creepy one. Did anyone see The Addams Family? That looked kind of cute. Anyone watch Hocus Pocus this year? I have not watched it yet. I might watch it tonight. We'll see. I had grand plans last night to stay up half the night and color because I'm definitely a night owl. I like to sleep in the morning, although sleeping consists of getting up no later than like 8 o'clock. So I don't know how late that really is. But I remember my good old days where I used to sleep to like 11 or 12. Can't do that anymore once you have a kid. But I had plans to stay up to like 2 or 3 in color because I didn't have work today. And about 10:30, I was asleep on the couch. So that didn't quite work out. So I didn't get any coloring done last night. And that's why I'm planning to do it today. My pencil is stuck in here. Hold on. Okay. So I'm going to be doing some more coloring today. I always color on Halloween, color and read. That's pretty much what I do. Before I started coloring, I used to just sit at the table and wait for the kids to come and I would read my book. But it's kind of easier to color while you're waiting for the kids to come trick or treat because it doesn't matter if you keep getting interrupted. Whereas when you're reading a book, it gets annoying that you keep getting interrupted and you forget where you were and all that kind of stuff. So much more fun to color while they come. And Amelia and I made cookies last night, so we have Halloween treats for my mom, and we're gonna have treats for the kids, candy for the kids, and all that kind of thing. So I'm just looking forward to seeing how the day turns out, and I would love to know if you guys did anything like that, if you give out candy to the kids, if you go trick-or-treating yourself, or whatever you do, whatever Halloween shows you watched. Anything. I just love the spirit of the season, and I love to know what other people do. It's quite interesting to me because I love just getting that feeling of, I don't know, comfy, cozy home feelings. And you know that feeling that you get when you watch a Christmas Hallmark movie? That kind of feeling. I think that's why everybody likes this so much, because you get that cozy, warm, family, fun feeling, and I love it. So I am going to close it up for today. Let me zoom out so you can see what we've got so far. That's where we are. So thank you so much for joining me for this Halloween color and chat. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Happy Halloween!